Hello and welcome back to Life is Strange 2 Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Now beginning episode 2, Rules.
Once upon a time, in a wild, wild world.
Oh, it's wild, alright.
There were two wolf brothers living in their home lair with their papa wolf. They all lived happily together, but one day, hunters took their dad away. Forever. So now the brothers were alone, and they had to find a new home. They started a journey through the great big forest. The wolf brothers wandered for days and nights, learning how to live on their own for the first time. They slept in the backwoods among creepy creatures and barely ate anything. They eventually found a peaceful orchard and were able to eat in peace. But they didn't know.
Not that peaceful.
Hunters tried to tie them up, but the wolf brothers managed to escape with the help of a friendly bear. He showed them how to survive and helped them find a warm camp for the night.
Cody, right?
That's when the big brother discovered that the little one was not an ordinary wolf, but a super wolf.
Mm-hmm.
That's how they found themselves even further, headed to the faraway land of their pop, where they hope to find peace.
The awesome adventures of Captain Spirit. Save file import has succeeded. Okay. It didn't succeed for the first episode? We didn't see that. To our grandparents. December 1st, 2016, Willamette National Forest, Oregon. This is literally... Oh, this is a month later. So this is still in Oregon. Guess that bus didn't take him that far. More of his little sticks and traps. Daniel, right?
Try with this one.
That one's too easy. Look.
Don't brag. It was too heavy for you a few days ago.
Wow.
Let's try to lift something else. Not too heavy, though. I'm a little tired.
I'm so glad Daniel took this little girl with us.
Right.
Not your usual shooting range, right?
Okay. So I think we have this... Ass to lift.
How about those cans? Can you fly them all together without dropping any?
Sure. Look.
That's awesome, dude. You're getting way better at this.
Wow.
Okay. Let's show Daniel some more stuff to play with before we call it a day. So Sometimes he looks so scared of himself. We need to work this through. Daniel is learning so fast. Wonder what the limits are.
Yeah, really.
No fucking clue what happened to Daniel. But at least I can help. Dude, it's getting late and cold. Let's get done with this practice session.
Okay, dude. Let's see if there's anything else.
It's getting late and cold.
Nope, we're done.
Let's get done with this practice session.
Hope we don't hurt the dog. But I'm really curious.
You could try and lift Mushroom.
Are you kidding? I don't want to hurt her.
Yeah, you're probably right. Let's leave the puppy out of this.
He is right.
Sometimes...
What?
He looks so scared of himself.
How about...
We need to work this
that
thing.
One.
I can do it with the small rods, but not the big ones.
You can do this. Trust me. Just relax. Focus.
Don't get a nosebleed.
I'll try.
Or what if it's stuck in the ground?
Holy shit!
I did it!
Like a boss. You're getting good at
you
this.
You see that mushroom? That was the biggest rock ever.
Come on, dude. That's just the start. Let's try something else.
Cool.
Thought he wanted the practice
like Coach Aaron.
Session to be
You're
over.
My power coach. A snowball fight?
Not yet. This is a new exercise, young apprentice. See if you can stop this in the air. Cool.
Okay, but you better not hit me. Like that time you gave me a bruise? Serious.
You won't let me, right?
Try it.
Okay, boop. Whoops.
Sean! You suck! You said don't hit me, jerk!
Sorry, I thought you would stop it.
Just a snowball.
Serious. Think fast!
Oh, nice.
Stop!
Whoa!
Well, that time I aimed for your head.
Daniel!
That's what you get! Happy?
Hell yeah, I am. That was awesome. You did it, man.
I did. So you better be nice to me.
Oh, boy.
Hey, that still sounds nasty. You're not getting better.
I told you. I'm fine. Just a little beat.
Well, you need to rest now. Superhero.
Can we go back now?
Yeah. Let's just fill up the canteens before we head back.
Almost stepped on the dog.
That cough has been going on for days, Daniel. I really don't like that.
I told you. I'm fine.
Yeah.
We've just been outside for a while.
Canteens. Wait. He stops if we go this way, right? Yeah, I don't want to miss filling out the canteens. We need the water. I just like to see different things, he says.
We should fill these up now. Don't want to go out during the night.
But we could use some help. Fill up the canteens. Condoms. Pocket knife. The blade needs sharpening, but it's still a useful tool. Wonder if someday Daniel could sharpen it with the power of his mind. House keys. Wonder if our home became a local attraction after the event. Not sure I can ever go back there. Jen's note. Brody, not Cody. Brody's souvenir. Stolen toy. I'm not giving it back to Daniel. He has to learn. Sorry. $9.03. We didn't have enough money to make it through the month, so I had to steal some food from the nearest town. Did some dumpster diving, too. For what? Money? Wonder if I should throw it away, too. Couldn't bring myself to do it so far. What about different pine cones? Jeez, don't know why Daniel keeps collecting these. What's Daniel's inventory? Oh, we got a bunch of more stuff to read. Feeling safer, first time since Seattle, thanks to Brody. Also, we picked up an odd mushroom on our way out. Probably a bad idea, but whatever makes Daniel smile again, I still have to tell him. At least now I know where we're off to. Puerto Lobos. R.I.P. Arcadia. Scootonitos. Well, that's our sketch of Daniel. Brody got us a room. He's a boss. He even left us some cash. Sir, hope you meet again one day. Chilling a sit. Been ages. Real beds. Almost too comfy to be true. I miss you so much. Maybe you could come back. Had to call Lila one last time. I missed her laughing. Hope she won't get in trouble. Now phone went out for a midnight swim. We couldn't reach the water from there. Safer that way. Off the radar. What the actual... What's happening to Daniel? What is he? When did that start? Same thing in Seattle? What will I do? Yeah, now he's realizing. November 1st, 2016. On the road again. Gonna find ourselves a hideout. Then Puerto Lobos. November 1st. So I keep my mind up. Clear my throat. Need money and supplies before we head to Puerto Lobos. We'll hide somewhere till we find out. WTF is up with Daniel. No idea how we handle this. Tired. Try to sleep. Okay. Warm here. Very bus. Taking you where you want to be. Where? We're getting off next station, wherever it is. Alright, so they didn't go far. November 2nd. Charity thrift store. In some town southeast of Albany. Found layers for Harry, Daniel, and me. Harry was cool. Slept in someone's backyard shed. 1 out of 5 would not recommend. It itches. The sock walk. Oh, the sock walk. Sleeping in a shelter. Fake names, they didn't seem to give up. Beep, no one seems to give up. Beep, here, they even let Mushroom in. Invisible. November 4th, 2016. Leaving town. Crackhead at the shelter almost snatched our stuff last night. Daniel freaked out and lights flickered. Can't risk another incident. Heading out for the forest again. Too dangerous to have him around people for now. I'm so tired. November 4th, 2016. Hitchhiked along route. Highway 20. Geologist on the way, Mount Jefferson picked us up. Not big on talking. Told her we were on a survivalist trip. LMAO. Most accurate lie I've ever told. November 7th. OMG. We found a house. A real house. Looks like an abandoned cabin. No one has been here for years. Was just here waiting for us. Hansel and Gretel style. Mice Palace. November 8th, 2016. Settled in. I think he named it after that group. He went to see a concert or something. Oh, he got his friend Lila tickets for that concert. Settled in. Had to leave Daniel to look for food. He hates me. I hate myself, too, for leaving him alone. Hope I don't get lost. 1 mile away, previous town, right, 1 hour plus zero equals traps. November 8th. Nearest town is 15 miles across the forest. No way I can commute there every day. Rock, sail, twigs, loose. Managed to steal canned food from a couple stores. Getting good at this, but not proud. Minute noodles times 6, tomato soup times 4, crackers times 3, ravioli times 5, applesauce times 3, bananas times 3, potatoes times 4. Think we can last plus or minus 2 weeks on these. We'll need to stock up again after. So all that effort I did not having them steal from the store, and now they're just stealing willy-nilly. That's funny. 32. Found my way back. November 9th. Daniel okay, but he broke some stuff around the house trying to use his power. We'll try to help him control it. Practice starts tomorrow. Focus it. Weight, size. November 15th. Number 16th. Ship, captain, crew. No crew without a captain, and no captain without a ship. Ship 6, captain 5, crew 4. These dice? When the ship, the captain, and the crew are complete, only then you can use the last dice to score some loot. Players with the highest loot over 20 wins the game. Ahoy. Dan and Shroom Adventures. He did it. November 17th. He broke the bottle. Sean Daniel lost again. November 23rd. Back to town today. Walk slower with the snow. Scavenge in trash. Found tons of good stuff. How can people waste so much food? Trash panda persona. November 24th. November 25th, Daniel sick, tired, and coughing. We'll go easy on the outside training until he feels better. November 26th, might need to go back in town soon for some medicine. Because BC equals 30-mile walk in the snow. Sean, Daniel. Well, you tried, Sean. I'm just better. How can this kid win every time in a dice game? Cheating? Maybe he's using his mind for it. Abandoned house. Souvenirs. Novelties. Body tricks.
Here we go.
The helitanker is over the wildfire zone. Get ready for water extraction. Ranger Diaz!
Oh, wow. Nice work.
Nice work, Daniel. Glad to see our training sessions are paying off.
Thanks to you. So glad I don't have to touch that water. It's too fucking cold. Oops.
Yeah.
Sorry. I said fucking.
It's fine.
It's fine out here. There's no one to hear you curse. Say whatever the fuck you want.
Cool. What did you find, Shroom?
That.
Aw, come on! Not again! We gotta leave.
A family of rabbits lives out here. Just like us.
Prank.
Sean? The family that lived here, what do you think happened to them?
Maybe moved out?
They must have moved out. Maybe to another state.
But they left all their stuff behind?
I don't know, man. Maybe they live in Florida and only come here every 10 years. Maybe they got tired of these woods.
Well, I'm glad they left. This is our lair now. I miss my friends. And my room.
Me too.
Sometimes.
Yeah. Me too.
Well, let's discuss the hole.
Hey, it's been a while since we last saw that rabbit who lives in there.
Yeah. I hope it wasn't eaten by a bear, or worse.
What's worse than a bear, Inanno?
I don't know. Wolves?
Don't worry. We're the only wolves around.
Oh! Almost forgot to check our traps today.
Look, Daniel!
Got my hands.
I think I saw that rabbit from the other day.
Got my hand stuck in
there.
He's
trying to get home.
Ooh! I want to see the bunny!
It's got me!
Fuck!
Sean!
My hand! Oh, dude. Your face.
Sean, you suck.
Come on, Daniel. I was just kidding around.
Moron.
Huh?
Damn. That kid is touchy.
Yeah. What's going on with him? Oh, is he making the leaves float? Oh, no, those are attached to vines or twigs, I think.
Finding that house was a miracle.
Yeah.
I'm afraid we can't stay here much longer.
Old canoe.
The family who owned that cabin really seemed to enjoy themselves here.
Well,
why never come back?
The canoes rotted through. Snowmen.
Good doggy.
Daniel's definition of a cool snowman.
You're such a good one.
I like it.
It's like an Etten half cyclops or something.
We really nailed it with his two-headed snow ogre.
Mushroom is so funny when she plays in the snow. Yeah, they're really badass. And Mushroom isn't even afraid of them anymore. Right, puppy? She loves it. Hey, get over here.
Amazing, we could talk about two different things at once.
Careful, little puppy. Don't catch a cold.
Daniel's getting cold. Let's get inside and warm him up.
Well, first we look around and see what's here. Old doghouse.
What kind of dog were you, Sandy?
A canine one.
A cool stray mutt like our little mushroom.
Are you getting hungry?
Not really.
Really? I'm getting hungry.
Again? You eat like a bear, but you don't gain any weight.
That's because I work it off.
Now, I wonder if he burns calories using his power. The carving here.
Runaway millennials. And part-time forest squatters. At your service.
Sean and Daniel are here. Old toy.
How old are these kids today?
Are they still alive? What, a trap?
Yep. Now me tonight.
There's gotta be some reason for it to want to go in there. Old axe.
Daniel helps me slice wood by holding the logs with his power.
Wow.
Pretty useful. Too bad this wood is rotten. We had to cut some more to keep the house warm. Daniel's not getting any better. He needs medicine and a real house with proper windows and heating.
Well, who knows when we'll have a real house.
I miss Dad's barbecues. His marinade with the achiote paste, jalapenos. Shit.
I've never heard of, much less tried, achiote paste.
You can't really name birds, right? Probably the name of a child who used to live here.
You never know. Could be for Maggie the Magpie.
It's so silent out here. No neighbors.
Patio
no roads.
Chair.
It's like we're on another planet.
A new planet. That's exactly what we need.
Yeah, they won't be able to get us there.
Must have been a really sweet spot to get a tan in the summer. Ooh. Yeah, not my kind of weeds.
You want to sit on the couch?
Daniel's getting cold.
Well, we're gonna sit here anyway. Cause we're a jerk.
I feel like this month has just flied over us.
Yeah, really, we didn't get to play it.
We're so lucky we found that old cabin.
This old cabin.
Gave us time to rest and process all that happened. Brody was right. We're stronger now. We look out for each other. We're in this together. These woods are so peaceful. So quiet. No planes, no highways. Just the river. Continuously flowing. I wish we could stay here longer. But Daniel's health is getting worse every day.
It's not good.
The food is running low. Will we need to move? Again?
Well, you do want to get to Mexico. Okay.
Sean, mushroom's getting cold. Can we go back inside now?
Hold on, one more look through. Let's check an inscription.
Sorry, guys. We don't take any more guests.
Keep out, wolves inside. Alright, so that's really it. Can we get in the doors?
We have to talk about it. Tonight.
We're gonna talk about it. Where we're gonna go? Can't get in that way. There's nothing here to look at, right? We can see inside a little bit.
Daniel's getting cold.
Yeah,
let's get inside and warm him up.
I know. Look.
We had to use Daniel's gift to break in.
I like that, his gift.
Ooh, cold.
Don't worry. We'll make a fire. We're pros now. Dude, that cough doesn't sound too good.
Nah, I'm okay. Just cold.
So you say.
You kicked ass today. Level up.
I did. That was so cool. It's getting easier every day. Oh no, Sean. This is a haunted house.
More like, uh-oh. It's time to go over the rules. I told you about showing off.
I was just... Whatever. Dude, I know the rules.
Let's find out. What's the first one? Hide your power. If you spin one plate in a diner, what happens?
People will freak out.
And when people freak, what do they do?
They called the cops.
Exactly. The second rule is...
Never talk about it.
Wow. Nice, Daniel. Because that's usually the hardest rule for you.
Shut up.
And the final rule?
I know.
Come on. You can do it.
Okay. Avoid danger?
Run from danger. This is the most important one. You know why?
I don't know. I mean, with my power, I can help us.
No, it's too dangerous.
No, it's dangerous. You have to find a different way.
So, what's the point of having this power?
Got me.
We don't know yet.
Maybe if I had used it before, Dad might still be here.
It's out of your control.
Daniel, you didn't even know. That shit was out of your control.
But look what happened to the policeman. Maybe this power is a curse. Or something.
Hey.
Could be.
We have no clue what happened.
Blessing or a curse, or both.
And it's not your fault.
Don't worry, Mushroom. I'm okay. Good puppy.
She must be hungry. What about you?
I'm always hungry.
Then let's grub out. I'll make us some dinner.
Yeah. Before she eats us.
Okay. Wood stove.
We're so lucky this thing is still working. Wouldn't have lasted long without heat.
I'm not gonna make the fire yet. Magazines.
The guy who came here sure had time to kill.
Okay. Chalkboard.
He's definitely a fast learner. Maybe too fast.
November 10th, first lesson. 17th, flying bottle. 21st, twigs and leaves. 25, small rocks. December 1st, big rock and snowballs. Wow.
Mecha robot ready for takeoff.
Coat.
3.
We scored with these clothes.
1.
Plus 5 street cred.
Haha.
Shoot. Poor doggy's out of water.
Refill it.
Hey, Shroom. You thirsty?
Where'd you get that from?
Good girl.
Family picture.
Daniel must have been pissed that day. Don't blame him.
He drew boobs. Pants. Dad and Maggie and John. Agatha Falls, summer 93. Okay. So that's Maggie, written outside. This is their picture, not the boys. Postcard.
Poor guy. I guess kids have to grow up anyway, right?
Maggie Hill, John Hill, Daddy Hill. Trying to piece together the names. Cascadia, Oregon. Hi, Dad. Say hello to your little girl in Miami. Yes, there is a sun here, and it burns. I love it. Tom knows everybody, and I keep waiting to meet Scarface. We're at his friend's killer condo with a beach view and balcony. I feel so spoiled, but I know John is at a castle in the Alps, so I don't feel so bad. Plus, I really like it here. What a great way to start the new century. I miss our vacation at the Secret Lodge, but I don't miss the raccoons in my room. Hope you can come visit soon after summer. Love you, Maggie. Broom.
I wish I helped Dad more with the house chores back then.
Build a fire in the wood stove, yes. Cigarette pack.
Wish I had more than tobacco, to be honest.
Yeah, well, beggars can't be choosers. Empty scotch bottle.
There was a little bit left when we came. Pretty disgusting, but helps staying warm.
Mushroom.
Oh, so now you let me pet you, huh?
Lizzie decided to bite
you. Intake. I get it.
Taking pictures of alien species, then report to base.
He's using his power again.
Kinda weird to use stranger stuff every day, but not like we have a choice.
Yeah.
I hate it when I hear Daniel crying at night. I can't do shit.
Can't bring him back. Unless you have a resurrection power. Mushroom's cushion.
Mushroom clung to Daniel on the first nights. But now she loves her bed by the fire.
Comics.
Thank God kids used to spend vacations here. Daniel would have been mad without these.
Free poster inside. My mustard is fantastic. Issue 3. It's just so silly, though.
High school feels so far away now.
Yeah, this is stuff which I already looked at. Was that a loom?
Can't believe how much Daniel's powers have improved over the last weeks.
Yeah, really.
This thing is strong as a rock.
Wow, you gotta look around this whole place. Sean's stuff. Oh wow. Letter.
Yeah. Daniel doesn't need to see this.
Hope Patient Center. May 25th, 2003. Dear Mr. Patrick Hill, this is a reminder for your scheduled chemotherapy appointment at the Hope Patient Center on September 8th at 2 p.m. Please read the enclosed instructions to prepare for your visit. If any questions, please call our main office at 555-HOPE. Sincerely, Dr. Fisher. He's not going to know. Who knows if he even can read chemotherapy? Much less know what it is.
No excuse not to binge read.
What book is it? Newspapers.
Of course. He's the town fucking hero now.
Oh my god, he's a monster. Local, yeah, see last, oh, chapter one, whatever. Local hero attacked by fugitives in store invasion. Police are investigating a store invasion by the two Seattle runaways believed to be responsible for the death of a Seattle police officer in October. Hank Stamper, owner of a gas station off Highway 5 and a pillar of the community, said he confronted the two brothers, Sean and Daniel Diaz, after they allegedly stole items from the store. Stamper told the police that the brothers attacked him before escaping into the woods. Yeah, I was scared. You know how crazy kids can be these days. He is a crazy one.
How can I feel bad for him?
Family recalls gentle officer killed in Seattle shooting. Ashley Matthews, sister of Officer Kindred Matthews. What kind of name is that? Kindred? Killed in a mysterious and controversial Seattle incident that left two dead, has released a statement regarding the threats she received and online critics of the officer. My brother was a kind man. He was in the force for only 6 months and shouldn't have been alone that day. My heart is with the Diaz family and all the victims of that terrible accident, including us. The police department needs better funding, so no officer goes on patrol alone if their partner is sick or unavailable. What happened here? Look at that. Looks like that was whited in. Kindred dedicated his life to helping others, especially children in at-risk homes, and he always volunteered his time for charity. It's easy for people to judge and attack behind a keyboard, but just as we mourn for others, we mourn for the loss of a brave public servant. Whatever.
Wonder where Brody is now.
And we read this.
Oh yeah. No internet.
We read this last episode. colored pencils.
I'm used to ink, so this will be different. Dead for a week. But at least we got some news.
Later.
This thing has saved our ass.
Yeah, really.
Thanks again, Dad.
No problem. And goes Leia.
Thanks, Hank. Dickhead.
Case closed 22.
Kinda reminds me of Dad's cheesy posters.
Gold crap. What is this?
I wonder how far it can go.
It's like a boy band?
Gotta love one-hit wonders.
Old phone, not working.
Feels almost good to be cut off from everything.
Almost.